Good afternoon, everybody. I am Vineet, and I represent Insolation Energy Private Limited, based out of Jaipur. We have recently started, and with a 60 megawatt of module manufacturing unit. In fact, at the onset, I would like to thank EQ for giving me this opportunity to represent Insolation Energy. And in particular, I am looking for Anand. Actually, all kudos to him for putting me, since I belong to business development, and putting me on dais for technology discussions makes me somewhat uncomfortable. But nevertheless, I'll try to enlighten myself for the benefit of all of you. When we talk of technology, I'll take a slightly different approach. I'll try to link it up with the evolution of mankind a few lakh years back, with leading a nomadic life, hunting animals and earning a livelihood for ourselves. Then somehow later, few thousand years down the line, we started living in a society, started with agriculture and started earning for per se ourselves only. With the new innovations, with the discovery of new alloys, metals, the things started improving and we started with the mass agriculture productions. Later on came the stage where we have industrial evolutions, where factories in European countries and later on to Asian countries, they started producing in masses, for masses in volumes, bringing down the cost. Then in 90s, we have, everybody knows where India is known for its IT revolution, where things getting started automizing. And now a stage has come where beyond this, the only scope which I feel left is of knowledge and being innovative. And there the role of technology comes. So as I discuss, there is no denial of the fact that our society development and progress has been primarily because of technology. And having recently started in this industry per se, because we are into module manufacturing, I have been observing for the last 2 days. In fact, I have been in this industry for the last 7-8 years. Everybody is trying to pass the onus on module manufacturers. We start from the bottom at 2.4. We started with somewhere around 18 rupees. Now, only things what we do is just look at the module manufacturers. Now, my point is, when we talk of technology, how a module manufacturer can achieve this? Are we producing silicon in India? Do we have a master manufacturing facility? We don't have. We start with only processing of cell into wafers into cells. That is also being imported. So to minimize the cost, what is the option left with the module manufacturers in India? Are we doing anything on the technology side? I don't think so. We are merely laying up the cells, soldering, laminating, and putting up the junction box. And finally, we are discussing about the prices. Is the government doing anything for the upliftment of the module manufacturers, or maybe putting up of silicon manufacturing or wafer manufacturing in India? Everybody is good enough for talking about the technology, but nobody is seriously putting in efforts or the funds for the upliftment of manufacturing, or maybe the finding new innovative technology for manufacturing side. There is no doubt that everybody is talking about cost optimization, but have anybody talked about the technology optimization? We are happy thinking about robotic cleaning, single axis tracker, double axis tracker, but we are not talking about the manufacturing side. So that is the reason we are not able to do much more things in the innovative ways, or maybe bringing over the cost. So that way, I think we need to have separate funds, especially when we talk about defense sectors. We have DRDO, sir. I think you were there. So government is putting up funds for DRDOs. For we are now having Make in India for defense sectors. We are having our own space program. But is there anything by the name of solar fund? No doubt we have clean energy fund, but that is for providing the subsidy. Nothing has been done till date for finding innovative products or maybe innovative technology for manufacturing. When I talk of manufacturing, there are 2-3 critical factors. There are manufacturing process, there is quality of raw material, and the trained manpower. The raw material, I think most of them is imported from China or maybe from Taiwan. There is hardly any Indian company which is doing much of research into this segment. When we talk about trained manpower, of late we have started with this Power Sector Council or Green Council and Skill India campaign. But it's a good step in a direction, but still, is there any sort of collaboration between the industry and the academia? Are we doing high quality research into this segment? We are merely training people for the installation and commissioning. We don't have defined research institutes specifically dedicated to solar energy. There are two, three institutes which are doing, and there is no collaboration between industry. I have seen, I've read also in few countries like Europe, wherein the professors or the leading scientists, they are deputed to the industry for a period of 2 to 3 years. So the, whatever they do at the laboratory level, that is also being replicated at the commercial level also. So that kind of setup is missing in India. Government is setting up funds for providing subsidy, viability gap funding. We are talking of lower rate of interest, but still nothing has been done for talking in terms of technology upliftment. So my point is this concern. Secondly, when we talk of solar for 25 years, no doubt we need to have a quality. As far as I understand, when I go to any of my possible customers, they only talk of, do you have the certificates? I think for most of them, what is more important is, do you have IEC, are you MNRE certified? But nobody talks ki what kind of quality standards you have, what kind of manufacturing practices are you following, can we have a look at your facility? Nobody is thinking of that terms. Maybe because of the pressure of 2.5 is so much on them that we are not talking about the quality. And especially I am talking in sense for rooftop, where the quality is of utmost importance, where space is a constraint, we need to get more of generation from a limited space. That segment is very unorganized. We have manufacturing facilities which are of 5 to 10 megawatts, which are doing it manually, but there are no standards. I am not against anybody, but still we need to have something very robust in place to have a quality check at these things also. So that at the end of the day, when things are produced for 25 years, yes, we can say with surety this is going to last for 25 years. And lastly, when I talk of quality technology, they are much more than just a production or a manufacturing side. What about after 25 years? Do we have the technology for safely disposal of maybe cadmium telluride or maybe the silicons? Nobody is talking of that. Do we have the technology for the safety? When we are putting up the plants of 100 megawatts of size, 500 megawatts of size, nobody is talking of technology or being innovative in safety, security and all. Yesterday, sir, you were talking about the operation and maintenance. When we talk about the people going in for rooftops, for panel cleaning, what kind of technology are we employing this? And when we are talking of megawatts of sizes, there are hardly any quality standards or the safety techniques or maybe the security drills and all which we are following. So the role of technology per se for manufacturing side is different, for safety side is different, security side is different. So I leave it to you or maybe to the government to think from that angle also, so that we can have more funds for the research, we can have more of industry academia interaction, we have more of trained manpowers, and let us not be just adopters. We are importing things, replicating hairs, and just trying to give them at a very competitive prices without bothering about the economies, without bothering about the innovativeness, without bothering about the technologies. So I wrap up this by saying that technology definitely plays a great role, but we need to put more of efforts, more of sincere actions into this. Thank you.